Hi everyone, today I'll be teaching you how to make a digital planner using Google Slides. So let's get started. First, you'll need to log into your Drive and start a new Google Slides project. From here, I just like to clear out the blank template. You can pick any blank template. And I'm just gonna add some words on there so I know what page is what. And then I'm going to start making the tabs for the slides for each page so I can link to them afterwards. So today we'll just be creating a very blank template, more of a structure for future uses and just so that you can get an idea of how to make a digital planner using Google Slides. I'm just adding a border. You don't have to do this, but I'm just doing it right now because then I can see what the whole page looks like. And then I'm going to add a couple of pages so then I can link to these afterwards. And then these are like the monthly pages, so each tab will correspond to a different month. And so I'm just adding all the months in, and that's how we can link the tabs afterwards. So now I'm just going to duplicate all these tabs. Once you get the hang of this, you don't have to do all this work. I guess this is more of an exercise right now to show you how this would work. So great using the Google Slides program because it's free, it's on the cloud, you don't have to ever be scared of losing your project. And it works great. So now I'm just aligning all the tabs. It's easy to do with their arrange tool. You can align them in the center and then space them out vertically so they're evenly spaced out. I guess this was a bad idea to add that large rectangle there because I keep grabbing it. Almost there. just gonna fix the corners here and we're almost done. Hopefully after watching this, you can kind of learn from my mistakes. Now I'm just going to add the links to each page. And then add the month. This would be good for testing afterwards, so you know you can check back to your tabs and to the page and see if they match. So now I'm just going to copy and paste these tabs to all the other pages so they'll all get the same length. This is how you make the whole planner link. I'm adding a few new slides here just so that I can also test it and see if the pages still link when they have new pages inserted into them. What usually happens is the link would still remember the page that it was on and it would link properly. So the new slides shouldn't affect the linking. And now we can start testing it. And you can test it by going to the present mode. You can click through all the tabs and in any random order to see if they land on the same monthly page as the tab. So now that we've checked that our planner works and all the links work, this is where the fun part starts. We get to decorate our planner, or actually add in the template that we want our planner to look like. What I did here is I designed a cover and the inside of the planner and what it would look like in Canva, and I exported the image. So now I'm going to insert the image as a background so that it can be a template throughout the whole planner by just adding it as a background, and I'm gonna apply to all the slides so that it'll look exactly the same, and just changing the front slide as a cover image and not adding it to all slides because we want the front cover to look different. So if you go here, you can see that the cover will look different than the rest of the pages. There you go, that's my planner. I'll just delete this. And now I have a cover, and I actually added tabs in my design, so I'm going to remove the tabs that I made here and make them transparent so I still get to keep the links, but the design will show through, and I'm going to do that for all the pages. So this is an example of a step that you don't have to do if you plan to do that in the future. It's kind of duplicated work. But for this purpose, we just added them all in so that you can see where all all the tabs are and how to link. So now to add my weekly templates, I also made it in Canva. Going to add it now as an image so it'll go over the background. I can duplicate this as many times as I want, but for now I'm just gonna add that one image, and this is my weekly spread. I hope this tutorial helped. If you like my videos and want more tutorial videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching!